Hello, class, Professor Haley. Today I want to go over discussion board 4 question with you real quick. I think it's very important that I actually talk to you about this. It says, social structure theories place much of the criminal activity into the lower class. If someone were to say to you that crime only happens in the lower class, how would you answer? Do all people in the lower class commit crime? Is that what it's saying? Let me explain something to you. The book's going to give you a lot of statistics, yes. But see, my job is to educate you, is to open up your mind, is to get you to think outside the box. I'm not telling you to agree with me, but I'm going to tell you right now, the criminal is the one listening to this right now on YouTube. It's your neighbor. It's your friend. It's everyone. And I can prove this, okay? Every time I have a class, all right, that I'm teaching in class, and we go over this, I make up a prefab form that says larceny, grand larceny, petty larceny, assault, you know, domestic assault, if you ever hit your brother or sister, smoking marijuana, I don't care if you inhaled or not, I'm just telling you, smoking marijuana, possession of, you know, narcotics, cocaine, burglary, etc. I go through it. Embezzlement, you know, if you work somewhere and you're like, oh, I'm stocking shelves, but I think I'm going to eat these cookies, right? Or you're working at the movies, you let someone in free. Yeah, there's another crime right there under the larceny statute. So I'm just letting you know that whenever I do this and I tell the students, do not write your name on the paper. Do not write it on the paper. I said, I just circle and put how many times you've done it for what you can remember within the last half hour. Do you know that my average criminal justice student, these are students that are gonna go into law enforcement, have chosen this as their career path, would spend an average of 15.4 years in prison if caught for everything that they've done. That's right. You know, even I put driving 25 miles an hour over the speed limit, it's really 20 over, you know, and you're at reckless, but I give them the extra 5. That's class 1 misdemeanor. Punishable by a $2,500 fine up to a year in jail in Virginia. Also, DUI, I put that on there. Oh, well, I'm not drunk. I've never driven drunk. Okay. Well, it's not about accusing you. It's not about condemning you or condemning anyone. I'm just letting you know, just like Winston Churchill once stated, he said, the truth is incontrovertible. He said, malice may attack it, ignorance may deride it, but in the end, there it is. So just open your mind, try to receive what I'm telling you. Know that there are 3 things in life. There's lies, there's darn lies, and there's statistics. But the truth stands alone. Thank you for listening to me, guys. Have a great day.